Hi friends, I'm Prasad from Bharat Test Guru. So I'm your aptitude faculty. So from today we're going to talk about your aptitude. Before we're going to talk about all your aptitude chapters, we want to know how do you improve your speed maths or maybe Vedic. How do you improve all this one? We want to know about this. Fine, let's talk about this. How do you go for step by step? First we start with additions, fraction, multiplications, divisions, then it comes to your squares, square roots, then cubes, cube roots, whatever it may be. Later we'll go for your LCMs, HCF, then we're gonna talk about all your percentage step by step. After this you will get some confidence. You'll get some confidence that, you know, my maybe speed will improve a lot. Have a look here. We have for preliminary 60 minutes of time. In this one aptitude, hardly we can spend for 25 minute time if you go for your bank exams and if you go for SSC exams. Maybe we have separate time, but we spend, you know, in a 60 minutes of time, hardly we also spend 25 minutes for aptitude or maybe 20 minutes max. Then further we split it up, 20 to 22 minutes we split for aptitude. But if you want to do this all this in a particular time, we need to improve our calculation part very perfectly. But because when it comes to banking, we have a simplification one topic, then quadratic equation, then we have a number series. In this three only we have lot of additions, we have lot of subtractions, we have lot of multiplication, all this calculation part we have in it. So actual you want to take 10 seconds, but you're taking 20 seconds for every calculation like this. You have, or you are getting in between, you know, 120 calculation. That means instead of taking 10 seconds, you are taking 20 seconds. That means you are wasting 10 seconds extra. That means 1200 seconds you are wasting. That means each minute having 60 seconds. You only come here, what is happening, what you're doing, 20 minutes extra you are wasting time here. That means in examination you go out there and you tell that, you know, every questions I can able to answer, but the thing is so the time is not sufficient for me. So the time is the only problem. When the problem is problematic to you, when your calculation part is very slow. So for this we came up with, you know, new shortcuts. Maybe if you are a fresher, it's gonna help you a lot. If you already went through that, if you are engineering background, if you some other background, that maybe this particular addition video makes you very little bit easy and sometimes a little bit boring also. But the thing is, we want to improve your calculation a lot. The people who hate maths, for them this video helps 100%. This video gonna help them 100%. But for other students, you know, later on we'll come to multiplication shortcuts, squares and everything. That gonna help a lot to you people, okay? This is not exactly to improve your calculation, but where do we apply these additions? Where do you apply these divisions? Where do you apply these squares, square roots? The application uses we want to know. Simply learning squares doesn't help you. Simply learning square root doesn't help you anything. The application, where do you apply to get marks? That is very important. Most of the people are, you know, just teaching the squares, square roots, multiplication, something. But application they want to teach. It takes a lot of time to know the students where to apply. But here we tell you the application also before we starting the calculation. Let me go over your further step how we are teaching a simple addition. Fine. Fine. Let me give up a brief idea. Let me come down slowly. Fine. Have a look here. First. See, this is our single digit addition. When our single digit additions are going up, so I'll solve with you a few of these additions like this. Then later on we'll be having a little bit quiz in the sense we'll open a timer. See, simply I'm gonna solve some 20 to 25 problems. See here, I given a set of 5. I will give you a certain time, then you have to write down your time here. Then you tell me how much time you're taking in a comment box, so that I'm taking this many like that. And this one also like this, 4 will be having 4 sets. You tell me how much time you're taking for 1 by 1, 1 by 1. 5, 5 will be one set like this. We have a 4 quiz by opening the timer. You come to know about everything. Then we came to your double digit one. Have a look here. then we came to your double digit. Have a look here. Then after double digit, same, we'll be having a timer here for the five problems. After double digit, let me go for your triple digit. Then triple digit, same thing, we'll be having a quiz based on triple digit. Then you come to know where you are. So then we'll come to your four digits, fine. But triple digit, we're gonna talk till triple digit, we're gonna talk in this video. When you're perfect, if you want more addition like that, also we'll post you. Fine. Before going to our agenda, let me start a few shortcuts. It's not exactly a shortcut. How do you do in a brain? What is the difference between calculation in brain and what is the difference between calculation in pen? Suppose someone gave you a number called 614 and plus something 37 or something. What do you do? For writing this number only, you're gonna consume more 3 to 4 seconds extra when compared with your brain. That's why make habit of using all these things in your brain only. So that means when you want to know 3 digit, a 4 digit, whatever it may be, you want to know first a single digit addition, then you want to know a double digit addition, then you want to know triple digit addition, then you want to know 4 digit addition. Directly you cannot climb to the 4 digit. You have to learn single digit, double digit, a triple digit, then 4 digit. This all things you want to do it. Do remember this strategy. Fine. Shall we go step by step for a single digit shortcuts now? Have a look here. Single digit. See, few single digits are very easy to add up. Any number. Suppose 10 plus 7. You can add up very easily. Why? Because any number coming with 0 at end, and as it is, the number will come, 1 will come. This is a school day shortcuts we are learning. So 10 plus 7, how much? 17. In the same way, 10 plus 17, how much it is going on? Because 10 plus 10, 20, 27 is my answer. So what is happening? For this, you don't need pen at all. You just need, with a brain, you can, as usually you can do it. Suppose 20 plus 17, how do you add up? 20 plus 10 is 30. That my answer is how much? 37. So these are going on very well. Have a look here. 40 plus 52, how do you add up? 50 plus 40 is 90. 5 plus 4 like this, 90. So that means then left with 2, 92. See, what do you learn from this? Any number ending with 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, till keep on goes. 100, 150, 200, 250, later on, whatever it may be, 500. These all things we can add easily. So that we're going to talk about your little bit shortcuts here. How do you add up any number by making a little bit shortcuts? Have a look here, dear. So let me talk about a few of a little bit, you know, we can call as small shortcuts, even though we neglected. We knew it, but even though we neglect them. So let me add 9 plus any number called 4. How do you add this number? Everyone know the answer, but the method is very important. I am giving 1 to this number from the 4, then this become 10, that become 3, my answer is 13. So that means I am making any one of the number equal to our any jackpot numbers. Maybe that is equal to 10. If it is equal to 20, you can make it up. Suppose 19 plus 14, how do you add up? I am giving 1 to this number, then that is equal to our 20 jackpot number. That is how much? 20, you gave 1 to this number, this became how much? 13. So what is happening out there? Your answer is total 33. Why? Because 20, then I am giving 10, that is total 33. Simply you getting, right? Any number with 9. So let me talk. 39 plus 36. What is happening? Give 1 to that number. How much will become? 40. Then this is 35. 40 plus 30, 70. My answer is 75. That is the process. So you want to know, for 9, if I add 1, that will become a jackpot number 10. For 19, if I add 1, that will become a jackpot number 20, that you all know. For 49, if I add 1, that will become a jackpot number 50. These all things you want to know. For 8, if I add 2, that will become a jackpot number 10. The maybe jackpot number, whatever is 8, for 18, that is 2. For 28, that is 2. That is obviously whatever ending with 8, jackpot number. If you want to make a jackpot number, you want to add 2. For this 7, you want to make 3. Next, for 6, it is 4. For 5, it is 5. Then what is happening next stage? For 4, it is 6. See what is happening? 6 and 4, same, and 7 and 3. That is coming in this process. Now you understand properly what is making. You have to remember the jackpot number. How do you make any number as a jackpot number? Then we can go step by step. So let me give you a friend a little bit number. Suppose 67 plus 35. How do you add this number? See, 7 is a big number and 5 is a less number. So we always try to make a 7 the big number as a our jackpot number. So I am giving 3. That will become how much? 70. This has to be done in your brain, not with your paper at all. 70 plus, I mean 7 plus 3, how much? 10. Then you left with 2. 102 is my answer. Like this, in a brain you have to go like this. Giving a number, that will become 70. 70 plus 30, how much? Because when any number ending with 0, then this number you don't want to concentrate. That means unit digit you don't want to concentrate at all. That is the process we want to go a step by step. May you understand properly? So that is a two digit number. When we comes to two digit number, then we're gonna talk about all these numbers. Fine, let me talk about this addition part perfectly. Have a look in this addition part. See, 3 and 7, what is this? 10. Then what is happening? I am giving 2 to this number, that become 10, and I am giving 1 to this number, how much it become? 10. Total we have 3 tens, that means 30. You gave 2 already, you gave already 1, that you have to remember how much you gave. You know, school days, you give some 1 rupee, 2 rupees to some of your friends, you'll remember like that. In the same way, now if you give some thousands of rupees to your friends, you remember them. In the same way, after giving something, how much is left? That means you left with 3. Then 30 plus 3, how much? 33. See, for making you to understand, I'm writing everything, but answer, you have to write it exactly, not other calculation part. We'll deal with this in our quiz part. And then what is happening? Have a look here. The next number. See, 3 is less to 7 and 3 is less to this 7. The total how much? From 6, I am giving 3 here and one more 3 left, I am giving here. That will become 20. Then from the 5, 1 I am giving how much? 30. Then my answer is 34. So, let me explain one more time. So, what is happening? Our 7 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 9. See, for 7, 3 is less. For one more 7, 3 is left. So, from this 6, I am giving 1, 3. From one more 3 is left. That means this 3 combination become how much? 20. Then from 5, I am giving 1 to 9. Then it will become one more 10. Then you left with 4. Oh, sorry. We came somewhere else in the ending. I'm sorry for that. So what is your answer? Your answer is 34. See, friends, if you already know, please try to go fast up and finish it, this stuff, everything. Yes, let me talk about your next number. This is 10. And then what is happening? Give 3 to this number, one more 10, 20. And what is left to you? Give 1 to this number. That is become 30, and you left. See, already you gave 3 here, already you gave 1. How much you gave? 4 you gave. You left with 2. That means your answer is 32. In a brain, read 30, in a brain, read 2. But with pen, you have to write down only the answer, not everything. This, you know, waste of. This is all waste of time if you write with your pen. This is only you want to write down for make you to understand I'm writing, but further, I don't write at all. You only observe it. Let me go for your next number. Before going to the next number, let me come down. Let's come to your this number. Fine, what happens to this number? So that is a 2 plus 6 plus 9 plus, I mean a 7 plus 5. Have a look here. So then what is happening with this number? So give 3, then what is happens? Fine, after giving 3, that will become 10. Give 1, that will become how much? 20. Then already you gave how much? See this, you gave 3 to this number, you gave 1 to this number, then you left with only 1, that means it's 20 and 26, 28, your answer is 29. You have to remember like this, how much you gave. So this 2 become a jackpot number, or maybe this 2 become jackpot number, that is 10. Now what is happening? 1 give to this number, 2 you give to this number. So that means how much? That is become 30, then you left with 32. See, friends, everyone having their own shortcut methods. If you know that, you have very speed, you can follow that. But this additions I am teaching you not for exam based, because by using this single digit additions, I can teach you a double digit. With double digit, I can teach you a 3 digit, then 3 digit to 4 digit. When your additions are perfect, multiplication will be perfect, then division will be perfect, squares, square roots, everything will be perfect. That's why our base is what? Addition. That's why we are starting with your small numbers. See, this 9 and 1 is my jackpot numbers. So then what is happening? So that is 10. Then 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 6, 13. We already discussed 7 plus 6. How do you make 7? By giving 3, that will become 13. So total answer is 23. You can make it up like this. Let's come to your next number. What happens to this number? Have a look here. 5 is there. With the 5, I am giving 2 to 1 number. Then what is happening? 3 to 1 more number shall I give? So from the 5. So what I am trying to tell you is, I am giving 3 to 7. I am giving 2 to 8 from 5. So what I am trying to do? 3 and then I am giving 2. That will become total here only 20. I left with what? 28. That is whatever further process he has to go for it. Let's go for your next number. Next number, what is happening? Have a look here. 3782, that is 20. 26 is your answer. Then what is happening with this number? So you left with, 8 plus 2 is 10. Then what is happening? That is 10. Then is 7 plus 7, 14. That is how much? 24. 24 plus 9 is how much? 33. Going very fast. 6 is there, give 3 to here and give 3 to here, then automatically you'll become how much? That become 20. You have to understand that part. So have a look here. What I'm trying to say is, this number, 3 here, that is 20, 1 here, 30, answer is 31. See how speed we are going for this number also. How do you make up every number? 6 plus 3 is how much? 9, and here one more 9, how much? That is also 18, you can make it up, 18, then you left with what? 3 give to this number, that will become 10, 28, then you left with only 2, that is, you understand, right? That means you are coming up, 30 exactly the answer. Any doubt in this? Let's go further, step by step, fast, we'll make it up, because these is additions, you already know it, but I'm just simply, telling you few tricks, because in between you may get a few shortcuts. Sorry for, always taking up this ink. Let's come to this number. What is happening? See, I am giving 2, I am giving 3, then become how much? 20, 29, 37. That's fine. That is our answer. Then what is happening? This 2 become 10. Then what is happening? 2 give and 1 you give, that become 30. After giving 3, your answer is 32. Then comes to your next number. What is happening? 5 is there. I am giving 3 to this number. I am giving 2 to this number. That will become 20. Then that will become how much? 20. And here it is 29. And that is here 32. That's it. Our further step. So then what is happening out there is, next number. Shall we go? We came at the end. Fine, let's talk about this number. So what is happening? 3 plus 2, 5. And here also 5. That is total 10. Then it is 19, 25 is my answer. Let's come to this number. This 2 is a jackpot number. You want to know about it. Then later what I have to do is, this is 10. Give 1 to this number. Why I am giving 1? Because 5, 5, jackpot number. 5, 5, 10. Then 1 you giving 8. That means how much answer is 28. Like this, you try to make every number which is equivalent to your jackpots. Fine. After this, you try to calculate all these additions properly. So because you try to do it, just pause it a little bit while you try to do every number, because it will be annoying all the time I'm doing. Let's come to your quiz now. What is this? This, whatever you do, the quiz is very important to you. The quiz is very, very important to you. Now, what is my thing is, I'll just zoom in so that you can see everything. Have a look here. Fine, now you can see every number, I think so. With this number, what I'm gonna do is, fine, have a look here, friends. See, you just simply open your phones. After simply, don't see your WhatsApp or something, anything like that. So after opening your time, just go to your stopwatch. When stopwatch is on, let me on the stopwatch in my phone also. Yeah, I on the stopwatch. What has happened out there is, before you start this 5 set of numbers, what are those from here? From here, before you start up your maybe a 5 digit one. So that means from where? From here to here. be ready yourself, you know, it's comfortable. Then what is happening? Five additions you have to do. After doing all these things, please write down your timer, or maybe if possible, please comment your timer down so that I can understand, you know, how speed you are going, the people. So if it is after opening your timer, so everyone be ready. I'm gonna open your timer, then by the time we'll start. On the count of three, you have to do it. 1, 2, 3. It's 5 seconds done. It's 10 seconds done. 15 seconds done. Stop. So please count yourself how many seconds you're taking for this addition, and you try to calculate why you took long time, which number addition, you know, annoying you, with which number you're facing a lot of problem. Be clear with those numbers. When you clear with those numbers, then only you can make it up. You can make it up. Let's come to your next number. You can comes to next number. After make it up, I gonna on your timer one more time. This time only I don't give 15 seconds of time. You have to improve a lot. Ready, 1, 2, 3, start. 5 seconds are done. 10 seconds are done. Stop. 12 seconds of time. You check in 12 seconds you did or not. And again, you check up where you're facing problem, what is happening with this, all these numbers. Then let's come to our next number. After checking up, let's come to next number. I'm gonna start up now. Ready, 1, 2, 3, start. 5 seconds are done. Stop. Your 10 seconds are done here. So in the 10 seconds, how you can able to solve it or not, you have to check yourself. Okay, fine. Last one shall we solve? We'll check the timer. How much time you're taking? Ready, 1, 2, 3, start. Only 8 seconds I'll give. 7, 8, stop. So you took how many seconds? 8 seconds to solve this single digit additions. Fine. Now you got it right. How you gonna make it up, all these things. Now next logic, shall we go to your double digit number? So I'm gonna talk about your double digit additions. Let's come to your double digit additions. Yes, we're gonna talk about your double digit additions. We already spoke about little bit shortcuts. How do you add all those numbers of double digit? Give me some time. See, how do you add up all these numbers? See, I wanna make a round figure of few numbers. When you talk about this number, minus 1 is less. When you talk about this number, minus 2 is less for 100. When you talk about this number, minus 1 is less. So what I'm gonna do is, from this 4, I'm giving 1 here, I'm giving 2 here, I'm giving 1 here. That becomes, this become 90, this become 100, this become how much? 70, and last number gonna become 80, and I left with only 19. See how simply I'm doing it. With the 4, here minus 1 is less for a jackpot number, here minus 2 is less for a jackpot number, here minus 1 is less for the jackpot number. Then what is happening? 19 will leave it, that become 80. Then it converts into a single digit addition, you know, this 19, I'm sorry. This converts into single digit addition. What is happening? 9 plus 10, how much? 19. 19 plus 7 again, how much? So that means you're going to come up, you know, very easily. Then 26, then 8 is 34, then 34. That means you got how much? 340 plus 19 automatically, you knew it. That means how much? 359 is your answer. Very easily we came up to this answer. Let's talk about your next number. What is happening here? How much is less? Minus 1. Here how much is less? Minus 2. And here is a plus 2 we have. And here also plus 2 we have. And here how much we have? Plus 7 we have. What you do is, these two numbers I am making one jackpot number. Is that fine to you? And from this 1 I am giving to this number, 1 also you give to this number. So then how do you convert? 30 plus 50 plus 80 plus, this all these things you have to do in your brain. 68 plus then 90. See what is happening? Only this number I made it alone, but everything is easy. Because when 8 is left, that doesn't matter, because 60 later we add 80. This is the thing you have to go in your brain. What is happening out there? 30 and 50 is 80. 80 plus 80, 160. 160 plus 9, that means 16 plus 9, how much? 25. That means 250. 250. Then next number, how much? 60. 310. I mean, 3180 is my answer. That is the step I am going for this. Let me talk. How much less? Minus 2. How much less? Minus 1. How much less? Minus 3. How much less? Minus 1. See, let's take any number. Let's take any number. Then we'll just give it up like this. How much is less? Total is, you know, if I talk about minus 7 is less. Shall we do one thing? Shall we take this 7 all the time? Give 2 to this number, give 1 to this number, give 1 to this number. After giving, what is happening? 80. See, this you can read it properly. Then how much? Then this is 90. See, you are giving 2 here, you are giving 1 here, you are giving 1 here. That means you give 4. Then you remain with only 83 plus 70 plus 40. What I am trying to make, see, every number is okay, but this number I made it alone, but not a problem at all. Have a look here, what is happening? 80 plus 90, I mean, see, 70 plus 40 is 110. 110 plus 90, how much? 200. 200 plus 80 is 280, and this is 360. Answer is 363. See how easily I am coming up to the answers of two digit numbers. It's very fast. Have a look here. See, here 2 less, here 2 less. Let's give, let's give, let's give. That become how much? 100, 90, 60. What is happening? 100. See, let's 100. Then what is happening with the next number? 100. So 90, next number is what? 60. See, these three numbers I made it how equalize. See, in my brain I'm making it. Then what is happening? So 7, give 3 to this number, that'll become how much? 100. See how I'm making it simplify step by step. Then what is happening? 24. I'll tell you how to do without pen also, but for understanding, let me do 3 to 4 problems. What is happening? 190, then is how much? 250, then is 350. 374, that is my answer. Okay, fine. Let's come to your next number. That is a very good number. Have a look here. This is one jackpot. Give 2. That will become how much? 70. 70 plus 70. How much? 140. Then what is happening? Better give 6 because that will become round figure more 100. Am I right? So that means 140 plus 100. How much? 140 plus 100. 240. Then 240 adding how much? 80. Because already you gave 60. I mean 6 already you gave. That is how much total here it is? 140, 240, 240 plus 80 is how much? 320. Then you left with only 18. So that is the answer, 338. That is the process we have to go. Let me talk about one more time. What is happening? 70, 70, 140, 140 and 200 is how much? I mean 100 how much? Now 340, then is how much? 80 how much? 320, then I'm adding 18. That means how much? 338 is my answer. See, nothing I'm doing in this. Let's talk about your next number. One minute, give time. Fine, dear. Have a look here how I go for other numbers. See, this 2 is my jackpot number here. Shall I make it like this? So that means I am giving 2 to this number, that will become 90 and 60. That is total how much? So that means these 2 are jackpot numbers. That is fine. So you're going to read like 90 and you're going to read like 60. Then let's talk about this number. It's a very good number. So what I'm trying to do is I'm giving 2 to this number, that will become 80, and I'm giving 1 to this number, that will become 100. So in your brain, how you want to read? This is 100 and this is how much? This is 90 and this is 60. Total how much? 90 plus 60, 9 plus 6, that is how much? 50. Like this, 150, that is 250. 950, 250, then this is how much? 80, 80, that means 330, 330. And see, this is 330 plus how much you want to add? Already you gave 2 here, already you gave 1 here. That means you left with only your 84. That is your answer. 333 plus 8, how much? 41. 414, that is your answer. That is easily we came up. Let's sum of this number perfectly in your brain. What is happening? This to our jackpot number, that is very clear to us. See, any one of the jackpot number you can find it fine, or maybe you can take this two also jackpot number, that will be very good to you. Why? Because that is near to 100. So that means I'm giving 8, that become 100. 140 is my answer. 140. Then what is happening? I am giving, you know, how much? I mean, from 7, just talk about this. I'm giving 1 to this number, that is how much? 30. And I'm giving 1 to this number, that is how much? 68. So how do you read up? 48 plus 92, that means this is 100. I'm gonna write 100 plus 40 plus Then next number, what I'm trying to do is 1 I'm giving to 29, that will become how much? 30. Then this one I'm giving to one more number, that is how much? 68. Then how much is left? 80. This is your best step. You can go for it. This is all in your brain. By practice, you will get it up. So total, if you solve it, you will get the answer something like around 337, something like that. Let's go to your next number. How do you make this as a round figure? That is very important. I'm taking 7, I'm giving 1 to this, that become 90, this become 80, that becomes 70. How much you giving? 1 and here 2 and 1, that totally you're giving 4. That means 83 plus, how do you read? 80, 90, 170, that is one more 70, how much? 240, 280 plus 83, that is very important. So like this, one by one, we want to go for a step. Let's go to your next number. Have a look here. Fine, I'm going to talk about this number. Have a look here once. Please give me time. What about this number? So what about this number? So suppose here 7, here 98, here 7 and here 88. So that means 2 you give here, 2 you give here, then you'll get automatically how much? This is 100, this is 90, the total become, you know, 190 plus 60 is 250. That means you already make two numbers as a round, three numbers as a round figure. Then what is happening? 7 plus 7, see, I'm giving 3 to this number, that'll become 100. That means one more 100, that is how much? 350. Already you gave how much? Here 3, that means you left with 24. Your answer is how much? 374. That is your answer. It is going on up there. So let me talk about other numbers in this pattern. So these two are jackpot numbers. I'm giving 2 to this number, that'll become 70. 70 plus 70, how much? 140. And I'm giving 6 to this number, that'll become 100. So how much? 240. You got it from here only, and here it is 80 left. So that means I'm gonna add 80. Then later, how much? This all has to be done in brain. 320, and your answer is 338. That is the process we want to go for a step. Okay, fine. Getting it right very fast. How I'm making a numbers as jackpot here. Let's talk about your next numbers. Let's just give me time. Fine, I'm gonna talk about the next numbers. Have a look here. Fine, please solve these numbers, and how do you come to the answer? Let me know about all these things. So I can take this 88 and 62 also. I can take, why? Because 2 I'm giving, that'll become 90. 90 plus 60, how much? That becomes 150. So that means 90 plus 60 is 150. Then what is happening from 7? I'm giving 2 here, I'm giving 1 here. So that means it become 100. So total, how much I got here only? I got it as 250 by the three numbers. 250. Then already you 3 you gave already. So 80 plus 84, 164. So 80 plus 84. That means how much? You're gonna add 164. That's it. So instead of this method, you can make first add 100. How much you add? 350. Then how much you want to add? This is in your brain calculation. Then how much you want to add? Don't add 64 as it is. Add 50 first. That means 350 plus 50. That is total how much? 400. Then you left with how much? 14. Then 414 in your brain. You want to add like this. 414 in your brain, not with your pen at all. Okay, I'm just telling the step by step. What is your first step problem? Giving 2, that become 90. 90 plus 60, 150. I got it properly. Then how much it is? 9900. This is till here three numbers we added up. Then this is how much? 250 we got it. Then what is happening? I'm giving 2 to this number. Already you gave 1 to that number. That is left with how much? 84. That you have to remember. So total how much? 84 plus 80. That is 164. But don't add up 250, 164 in a confusion manner. If possible, you can split like this also. 250 plus, 150, and next is 14. I'm so sorry, that is 14 only. Then total how much? 250 plus 150, how much? 400. 400 plus 14 is how much? 414 is your addition 1. Shall we talk about this number 35, 35? We got it. It's a very easy one. 70. Then later on we'll talk about some other numbers. So what I'm trying to do is I'm giving maybe 2 to this number. They'll become 100. So total 170 I got here only. Then it is 83, 84. How much? 160, 167. Have a look here, friends. 17 twos are how much? We knew it. That is how much? 340. For 170. 170, that is minus 3 is less, so that means I am giving 3, then later I'll take it back. So that means total how much? 340 minus 3, my answer is 337. Like this also I'll go for the addition. There are a lot of techniques are there, you can go in your own ways, because 167 minus 3 is less, so I'm considering this as a 170. I'm considering this as a 170. Fine. Let's talk about your next number. What is happening? This two is one pair, this two is one pair, or maybe you can consider these two as one pair. Why? Because if two you give here, that will become 50 and 50, that is 100. So total is 100. So 100, and here what I'm trying to do is I'm giving 2 to this number, that will become almost 27. So 100 plus, after giving 2 I left with only 80, that means my answer is 180. Then what is happening here? 37, there 27. 30 and 20, that is how much? 50. 7 and 7, that is 14. That means total 64. 64 is my sum. So first you give 20, that will become how much? Jackpot number 200. Then you left with 44. Then your answer is 244. Fine, all the time you want to follow your jackpot numbers. That's it. Let's come up this number. I am giving 3 to this number, I am giving 2 to this number, that will become 80. This has become 80, and that is also become 90. So 80, 80, 160, 160 plus 80 is how much? 250. 250 plus 40, how much? 290. 290 plus 39, give 10, that will become 300, and you left with 29. 329 is your answer. Like this, step by step, we'll go for, you know, one by one, one by one, one by one, okay? Okay, will you please solve it and tell me about this one? How about this answer? What I'm trying to do is for this number, I am giving 2 to this number, I am giving 2 to this number, I am giving 3 to this number. So that means I already gave 7, I split it 7 properly. That means I came up everything 100, 60, 20, 90. That's it. So we came up, you know, very easily. How I got it? 100 and plus 60, how much? That is total 180, that is 260. 260 plus 34. How do you add up? 260 plus 34. I know how to add up, but we're talking about, we're stressing more on your shortcut. So 260 plus 34 is 294. Fine, now let's talk about your one more number, next number. What is happening with this number is, let me talk, this two is one jackpot. Then later on what happens, 2 and it is 40, 70 plus 40 is how much? 110, then later we have to add up this 4, 3 and 8. That is only, tell me the answer how much you'll get. And for this one also try to solve it very fast to solve. And you know, for a little bit practice, and then we'll go to our timers. Firstly, we have to go for your timers. Please solve that number also. Let's come to your timers. That is very, very, very important for us. So make sure that you are ready for your quiz now. So then I'm opening my phone for a stopwatch. We'll start with that. Let's add up. I'm gonna start with your stopwatch. Ready? 1, 2, 3, start. 5 sums you have to do. 5 sums you have to do, and let me know how much time you're taking. First, it will be confusing. Not a problem. Keep moving. Keep moving. It's already 18 seconds is done. 18 seconds is done. Twenty-eight seconds, 29 seconds, 30 seconds is done. we're done with the 40 seconds. Please you calculate how many you can solve with this. I think you don't need answer. It's not a problem. This is not that tough also, but we are just in a practice session. And now, please check up where you are doing wrong and where doing right and everything. Please check and tell me, please. Fine. Let's go for your next number. I'm opening your timer now. On the count of three, then start. Ready? 1, 2, 3, start. Your second, 7 seconds, 8 seconds are done, 10 seconds are done. Start. So 35 seconds are done. Please check yourself. Either your speed is improved or it's diminished. Fine. Please check it up. If it is done, we'll go to next number. Ready? Are you gonna start after the count of 1, 2, 3? Not now, please wait. Let me start. Ready? 1, 2, 3, start. Ten seconds done. Twenty seconds. 30 done. Stop. Please check it up. 40 to 45, how is going on? 40 to 35 and then 35 to 30. Is that improved anything or maybe it's diminishing? Something you have to check yourself. If you want more additions to practice, I'll give it up. Not a problem at all. Then let's go for your next numbers. Next numbers. Let me start. Let's go for your two-digit numbers, then again. Shall we go now? For the last, maybe four numbers. Ready? 1, 2, 3, start. Take 30 seconds. 25 done, more 4 seconds. Stop. So, out of 30, I'm sorry, out of 30, next, how much you took? See, you only check yourself where you are going right, where you're going wrong, and where is your difficulties and everything. So, please know your pros and cons regarding everything. For the next video, we're going to discuss about your 3-digit additions. Then 4-digit additions, then we'll go to your multiplications, then we'll go to your divisions, step by step, everything we're gonna discuss in this. Please subscribe us, so we're gonna come up with a lot of videos, not only in aptitude, we'll come up with your English vocabulary, and we'll come your static GK, and we'll come your banking awareness, and for SSC general knowledge also, general awareness also, we'll come up with everything we're gonna talk. According to the exam point of view, if you like our video, please like us, subscribe and comment below for any suggestions. And if you want more additions for practice, please comment below. I'll provide a lot of additions to you so that you can practice, so that you can find out how speed you are. Don't forget to comment below that how much speed you can make it up on an average of single digit additions and double digit additions. Make sure that a single digit additions, 5 set of additions, you have to be done within 10 seconds. And this double digit additions, you have to do it within 25 seconds. But at the starting, it'll take a long time, not a problem. Keep moving. Thank you for visiting, for watching our video.